Hi, now that we have the dynamic get in place, let's add that to a site view and look at the initial implementation. We'll go to site view and then click on new. But since we already have that view created, we're just going to open it called preacher. You'd see that there on the right hand are three fields that you can populate with your dynamic get methods. The first one is where you would add all the custom dynamic gets, and there you can add multiple custom dynamic gets. The second one is where you add your main dynamic get. As we explained in the dynamic get tutorial, you can add one main get method per view, per site view. Since it's gonna be built in the model either as a get item or a get items, it is all depending on the main get, whether it's gonna be a list or just an individual item. Yet you can include dynamic gets, custom dynamic gets, as many as you like, to also have this data available in your view. So these two first fields are used to load the dynamic get to the view. The third one is used to display the possible way that you might want to implement the code of a specific dynamic get option. You'll see that this one only displays possible main gets, this one only displays custom gets, whereas this one displays both the custom and the main kind of gets. Now, if you select let's go to one of these main gets, sermon, this one here, you'd see that it shows us a list print out of the possible ways that you might use the result set. Obviously each of these are copy, you can copy by clicking in it and then clicking on either right click and copy, or you could click on Control V or Command V, sorry, Control C and Command C to copy respectively the content. Sometimes you might only want to use part of it and not the echo statement included. Then you can click from the area where you want to copy, and then before letting go, click on Control C or Command C in a Mac to ensure you only grab that section of the text. Once you let it go, it will select the whole block, and then obviously if you copy it, you will copy everything. As you can see, we then used that this code in our default view to display the data in a PHP fashion. You can also get the custom get here. Let me show you that one feature. And like you see, it says that that value is going to be in this feature. And if we look here at the top, that is what we checking for here. Make sure that we have a preacher, and then this block basically deals with displaying the data related to that information. This one here checks whether the main items are on the page. And now the main items, as you can see, is sermons, preacher, ID, get list. So if I go down to that sermon, preacher, I get list, you see that again, it shows me that the values are in items and it's an array, so I can loop through it and target the object values. And that's what's being done here. We're first checking whether it's on the page, the values. Then if we see that it is here, we make use of templates to display the various layouts, and I will explain in the next tutorial how to use templates and layouts inside of your site view. But this is just quickly showing you how to connect a dynamic get structure or methods to your view, and then how to make use of the data that are being passed through to the view. So this data structures here on the right in red is basically the data structure that you can expect from each one of these. So if I was to take number sermons as the method that I want to see, then it shows me that that's possibly the way that it will be packed into the data set. So it will be found in this number sermons is how. Now that could change depending on your custom implementation in your components, custom coding areas. You might move this data from that position to something else. But the reality is this at least gives you how it would have looked without you, you know, leaving the normal path. So this is just proposing the data set structure, which ideally would be that you would take this value here and maybe do this in the code. Do a var dump and then exit, and then basically do a build and go look at this view to see exactly the structure. If you're finding that this structure that we've shown isn't working exactly as expected, often this helps us to sort of map the array and see where what value is found. Same goes with any of the others. You can just grab that area that you want to peek into and then put it in a var dump, do a build, go look at this page in the front of your site, and you can see exactly the structure of this object here, whether it's an array or an array with objects or whatever is placed inside of this value set through the dynamic get method. Now I just want to quickly peek at the way that these methods are actually becoming available in your view by going to the code and just looking at some of the implementations that we've done. Okay, as you can see, we've gone to the front of the site, sermon distributor, models, and we have opened the preacher model. Here is the preacher model. And as we scroll down, you see that there's a get list query. And this get list query gets sermon as the A table, and then series as the C table, preacher as the D, and categories as the, C, D, B as the B table. And then it looks for a value in ID, and then sets it equal to preacher and ensures that the person has access level to the item, that it's published, and then it returns it. So that is the get list query in the model. Now if you go back to our interface, you'd see that we have sermon preacher ID get list as the main, and I've opened that dynamic get here. Let me just see, where is it? Here it is. And you can see that sermon is set as A, the main table. Then if we open here, you see that series is set as C. We're only looking for those values. Preacher is set as D and only those values. Statistics E, but it's a list. See, it's multiple. These that are single are part of a list query, whereas the multiple will have its own object, its own method. And we'll look at that quickly. And then we see in the DB table that we have category as single, as B, only those values. So going back to the code, This is the get list query, and in the get item, after we have received the items, we loop through them, and then in this function here, get sermon statistics, and then a generated string, randomly generated string to ensure no conflicting with other methods on the page, puts the values in ID sermons statistics E. So that's where the values are placed. And then basically we have a custom method here, like we've shown in the dynamic get. You can add custom methods, and it then returns the items to the page. And in the page you have a file that is called view.html.php. If you open this file, you see that there is a get items method being used to place the items in items. And so at the moment we are actually in the view at this stage, and that means you can access this set of values inside of that class field. And so if we go back to our component builder, you would see if we were to select that method, there is the items corresponding to our code. And so we know that the ID and the asset ID and all these are in there. And if we scroll down, you'd see that there is an ID sermon statistic E. See it there? Now, so that means in the array there is a key value which has another set of array values in it. So you can target these data sets by corresponding pointing values. So that is just looking at the main get. Now, if we were to look at the other custom get that has been added, we will see that here is preacher, which is a custom get, a custom method that has been added. And it also has its set of values and its database structure. And remember we said that we want it to be linked to the preacher's ID. So again, it checks for the ID and then sets it to ID and returns the result. The same goes with the number of downloads. It's also a custom method that's set to this view because of the custom get that was added. And here is the number sermons. And if we go back to our view.html.php file, we see that those values are respectively being added to preacher, number downloads, and number sermons. And you can actually use these values in the view by targeting this number sermons. Now the view itself is, as you should know, inside of the template folder under the views preacher. And this main view, as we call it, or the default view, is where that code that we on the page that we're looking at right now is being placed. All these others are the templates that are extending the site view, and they possibly are extended through layouts that are available in the layouts folder. So we are now just looking at adding the custom get methods to the page. In our next tutorial, we'll go into depth about adding templates to your custom site view and making use of these data sets. So that is how you link them. You first create the custom get, then you come here, you link these. So these are the linking fields, and these are just so that you can see the code snippets of making use of these fields respectively. And that is custom gets added to site view. Thank you for watching.